It is said that everything that we want lies on the other side of the fear. And I'm saying this because fear has been such a dominating factor in every aspect of my life. Can anybody in this room tell me what is the most common fear in this world?
Public speaking.
Public speaking.
Precisely. And while I was drafting my speech, I realized that the fear of public speaking is actually surpasses the fear of death itself. So in a manner, technically people are more afraid to speak than to die. And I believe that I am the epitome of that notion. A very good afternoon to fellow Toastmasters and distinguished guests. My name is Abhishek Banerjee, and I am not in any way related to our Honorable Chief Minister. For reference, our Chief Minister, the nephew of our Chief Minister, also has the name Abhishek Banerjee, so not confused maybe with him. I was born on 3rd of October 1996 in Kolkata itself. I have a sister, Moshe Banerjee, who is 1 year older than me. My mother, Joyce Banerjee, and my father, Thomas Kumar Banerjee, pampered me a lot when I grew up, probably because I was the youngest sibling. My early childhood memories include systematically dismantling every single toy that I laid my hands on, and one of my greatest achievements was at an age of 5, I completely dismantled our own television set. I did that at an age of 5, and it was in the early 2000s, so in those days, we didn't have those flat LED and LCD TVs. They were huge cathode ray tube monitors, as I know it. So I destroyed it at an age of 5. That was quite an impressive task. In par with the adventurism I had in my early childhood, once I had an insistent desire to chase a sparrow. So I ran after it in our terrace, and it so happened that on that day it was raining and the surface of the terrace was all wet and slippery. And the inevitable happened. I slipped, but what followed after was even worse. Because while slipping, I managed to fall on my face. So I chipped my front tooth a little bit, the scars of which I still wear today. I did my schooling from South Point and South Point High School. Academically, I was never a very good student. However, when I advanced to my high school, I was introduced to the science stream, and I gradually felt interested in studying because I really liked the science subjects. However, all this while, I remained segregated from the common mass, and my comfort zone included only a handful of people. So that I feel that kind of left a void in my character, because physically I was like a little dynamite, but verbally I was like a wet firecracker, trying but cannot explode. And that became very clear when I tried my hands at debating in class 12. When I started to speak, I practically froze and couldn't utter a single word. So, and I still remember vividly that in my junior school, when a teacher would ask me to volunteer and say something in front of the whole class, I would, while all of my friends would just jump on their desk and raise their hands like this, it is for an opportunity, I would softly and stealthily slide behind my desk like a frail little snake. What I was hoping was that the teacher would notice me, but the exactly opposite happened. The teacher would always notice me and always pick me up, and as a result of which, I was always forced to volunteer to speak, to which I always replied that I always offered some lame excuses, and the excuses were endless. Off the top of my head, I remember two excuses. I would always say that, "Ma'am, I have to go to the toilet." or I would say, ma'am, I have a sore throat. I cannot speak to you. And that was me basically lying to myself because I wasn't really comfortable in speaking in front of a live audience. However, currently I'm in Jadavpur University. I am a third year BE construction engineering student. And so a few months back when my good friend Devapriya told me about the existence of Toastmasters and her interest to become a member of it, I knew that I had to do this because I was determined that I would get rid of this phobia that I have. And because to me, this fear that I have is pretty much like anything else. If someone is afraid of heights, he should go on top of a multi-story building. If someone is afraid of a bug, he should get a bug maybe. And if someone like me is afraid of public speaking, he should face the crowd, headstrong. And I know this because there is no around this. As I said earlier, everything that we want lies on the other side of the field. And I think I am gradually venturing to the other side. And I think that, and I know that I am not afraid now.